If a particular client wants to perform some operation, so there in the web page they may find the controls like buttons, text box, checkbox, or anything else. So in order to make any action, a client will click on the button or checkbox or do anything such that it will create an action due to which some task will be done. So those are nothing but the events. So and here we will learn like how to deal with the event handlings. So basically whenever a client clicks a button or maybe press a key or type anything in the text box or any such interactive things, those are nothing but the events due to which they may expect some task to perform. Like when I'm entering my username and password and clicking on the sign in button, I'm going to do the login. So on that button click, that login operation should take place. So whenever such kind of events take place in the ASP.NET web applications, all the events will be generated on the client side, because on the client, on the browser, user would be having our web page and where only they will click the button or any similar task. But whenever you will work on ASP.NET, you will observe like whatever the controls, whatever the ASP.NET controls you are working on, they will be executing on the server side. Means whether the client is clicking on the browser, which is on the client side in a separate machine, but the resultant, but the action will be executed on the server side. So the event handlers will be there on the server side. They will be having a subroutine which will be doing some operation for which a client is probably looking for. So apart from that, in ASP.NET we have some different kinds of events like ASP.NET page lifecycle events, which we have already seen. This will happen on a particular sequence which we have discussed, and particular things will be going on. But after that, what a client can do is the client side events. And in the client side events, as I said, button click is a very common example. Apart from that, we will see few more events which can be managed by the client but will be executed on the server side. Apart from that, we do have some server events, like when you start the application, when any new request is generated, whenever any new session is generated. These are all the server side events. Here we are not going to discuss server side events. We have already discussed about page lifecycle. In our coming videos we will discuss what are the server events, but here let's see how to deal with the client side events. So let's have a practical implementation for the same. So now, as in the previous video, I have already created this particular website. Now in order to work with the events, first of all I'll have to add few controls. So in the demo I'll just show you a control called button. So generally you will find the toolbox on the left hand side of the page, but if in the window you will not find on the left hand side, what you will do, you will just come to the view and here you can see the toolbox. So just click on the toolbox and here on the left hand side you will find it. So here from in the button, just make a double click and it will be added. If you want to see the preview, you can simply come to the design pane at the bottom and here you can observe like there is a button control. Now I will simply click on this button to choose it, right click on the button and come to properties. Here in the text property you can just write anything which you want to see over the button, like here I am writing click here. Alright, so here is my button, and whatever I want to do here, I can write that particular code by the double clicking over this button. So as soon as I will do that, this is something called the event handler, which will reside on the server side. As here you can see, there is home.aspx.cs. So whenever a client will make a request, this ASPX copy, means the HTML part of this ASPX page, will be sent to the browser so that he will be able to see the page. But whatever the definition I will write here in the button one underscore click, that will always reside on the server side. Also you can observe in the source, like whenever I'm adding any control
or any form or the head, they have the attribute called runNet is equal to server. Why? Because whatever you will be adding in the ASP.NET, all execution will be taking place on the server side itself. And even in this particular case, there is a code file called home.aspx.cs, which you can see here in the page directive. This CS file will be containing a language called C#. Code file name is home.aspx.cs, and it will be inheriting, means the class name would be home. So even here, when you will come, you will see the, in the home.aspx.cs, there is a class called home, inside which there is a button, and in the button there is a method called button1_click. Alright, so on click event, this method will be called, and this method is residing right here inside this code file, that is in C#. And every time when you will double click over a particular control, it will generate an event handler like this, and it would be having the protected void. Void means the return type, it will not return anything. The sample method name, that will be containing the control name underscore event name. That is, button one is the control name and click is the event. And after that, object center and event args e, because we will be using a delegate called event handler, which is having this signature itself. So object center will contain the information of the sender control, while event args will be containing the information for the events. So if I want to perform anything out here, I will simply use the response object, response.write. So we have already discussed about the objects of ASP.NET, and response is one of it. So as soon as a client is clicking on the button, it is nothing but a request, and according to that, I'll have to give a response. So response is the object, write is the method, and here I will write a message like button clicked. Alright, and after that, inside this only, you can also use the HTML tags also. So let's execute this page now. Just click here, and here you will find button clicked, the message which I wrote inside the definition, inside response.write. So doesn't matter which control you are working with, every control would be having a default event, and when you will interact with that, that particular event will take place. For example, if I will go for any other control such as text box, so let's come to text box first, and as soon as I will make a double click over text box, the default event for this text box is text changed. Alright, but if you don't want to go for the default event, we also have an option. I'll have to come to the properties, and here on the top you can find there's a button for events. And inside this, you can see number of events are there. So as soon as I will double click on any of the event, like for the text box, I will use data binding event. So double click over that, and I will get that text box 1 underscore data binding. So similarly, you can also go for any particular event which is being provided for a specific control in ASP.NET.